everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet my absolute favourite square of all time, the Sunburst Granny Square. Now this square is particularly trendy at the moment, especially when done in sunflower colours like the one on my table. But it looks equally fantastic in just about any colour, so it is a fantastic one for blankets and scrap projects. All the information for the yarns I've used and the written pattern is down in the description box below this video, so don't forget to click show more to find that information down there. All right, let's leap straight on into how you crochet this absolutely fantastic sunburst granny square. To begin, pop a slip knot onto your hook. Then chain four. Then join with a slip stitch to that very first chain you made to form a little ring. Now we're going to work all of our stitches for this first round into this central ring, and we're also going to crochet over the tail from your slip knot right in the very beginning. So for this first round, start by chaining three. Now that chain three counts as your very first double crochet of the round. Then into this central ring, you're going to work 15 double crochet stitches. That's an American term double, so yarn over first before you go into the ring, drop your loop, you'll have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. So that's one. I need 14 more of them worked into this ring. Now, if you're running out of space, scooch those stitches along. Once you have all 15 stitches, it is definitely worth taking one tiny moment to double check your stitch count at this point. And once you're happy you have 15 double crochet stitches, we're going to slip stitch to the top of that initial chain three that you made. So just pop your hook in the top, form a slip stitch to join that circle up, then chain one, grab your scissors, snip the yarn end, but leave quite a length to actually weave in, pull up, out, and pull it tight. Now flip it over. If you've been crocheting over your tail here, if you pull that, it should snag this little hole closed. Don't worry if it's not perfect. It just cinches up that middle section a little bit better. Then grab your large eye needle, thread up these two tails and weave them in. It's a lot easier to just weave them in as you go. Just running this through the top of some of the stitches and then down the back and running them underneath along here. Now grab your next colour. So round two, is the puff stitch round, and you're going to join your yarn to any one of these stitches around. So you've got your chain three, which counts, and then 15 double crochets. I like to join mine just after the chain three, so in the next stitch along. That way, as you work your way round, it's a lot easier to see where you pop the last couple of stitches, because you'll be able to count how many you've just done. So ideally, in that stitch after your join, but honestly, it doesn't matter which stitch you join to. So just pop your hook underneath any of those stitches and pull through your new colour. Now for the puff stitch round, we're going to start by chaining two. So you're going to yarn over, put your hook back into that stitch, draw up a loop. I'm also crocheting over the tail of this rust colour, and pull it up nice and tall. You'll have three loops on your hook, yarn over, go back into that same stitch and draw up a loop and pull it up nice and tall. You'll have five loops on your hook. Then one more time. You'll have seven loops on your hook. Once you have seven loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all seven loops. Then chain one to secure your puff stitch. That's your very first puff. Now into the very next stitch, yarn over, draw up a loop once, twice, three times. You'll have seven loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all seven loops. Then chain one to secure. We're going to repeat this puff stitch in every stitch around. By the end of the round, you will have 16 puff stitches. Now I'm going to carry on going around and I'll meet you towards the end over here to clearly show you where you put your last couple of stitches, particularly when it comes to that join of the chain three on the round below. So in every stitch around, yarn over and pull up a loop once, twice, three times. When you have seven loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through all seven, and secure it with a chain one. If at any point you're unsure where to put the remaining stitches of the round, count how many puff stitches you've already done. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 13. So I know I need 16 puff stitches for this round. I've already got 13. So the best way is to look to see how many stitches, clear stitches, you have left. And I've got 1, 2, 3. And this third one is at the top of that sort of chain three section here where I joined. It's just a handy way to spot where you put your next one and you don't accidentally try and crush another one in. It's also good for working over that chain three in your slip stitches. So always just stop, if unsure, stop, count how many puffs you have and how many stitches you have left. And that way you can clearly see where you place your remaining stitches. So once you have your 16 puff stitches for the round, we're going to join with a slip stitch into the space in between the next two puff stitches. So reach across, skip that first puff stitch and go into that space to do your slip stitch. It just brings your puff stitches nice and close together on this round. Then chain one snip your yarn, leaving a length to weave in after. Pull it tight. Now what I also like to do at this point is take my hook and just weave this end in under a few of the top of these stitches. It just gets it out of the way for a minute so it's hanging at the back. So now we're ready to begin round three, so grab your next colour. So with your new colour, we're going to join in between any of your puff stitches from the row below. So split two puffs apart, pop your hook in, and draw through your new colour. Now to begin round three, we're going to go ahead and chain two. Now for this very beginning space, you're going to yarn over, go into that space there, draw up a loop, you'll have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, and then stop. Ignoring those two loops on your hook, yarn over, go back into that same space, draw up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, then stop. Three loops on your hook, ignore those, and one more time, yarn over, go into the space, draw up a loop. Five loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two. So for this very beginning section, you have a chain two and three half completed double crochet stitches hanging from your hook. You'll have four loops on your hook at this stage, so go ahead and yarn over and pull through all four loops. That's your beginning cluster made. Chain two. And now we're going to work double crochet four together in the remaining spaces between your puff stitches. So into the next space, yarn over, draw up a loop, three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, and then stop. That is one half completed double crochet hanging from your hook. We want four of those in total. So again, yarn over, go back into that same space, draw up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, stop. Two half completed double crochet stitches. Again, yarn over, back into that same space, draw up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, three half completed double crochet stitches with four loops on your hook. We need four, so one more time, yarn over, go back into that very same space, draw up a loop, yarn over, pull through two. You'll have five loops on your hook and four half completed stitches hanging below. Yarn over, pull through all five loops, then chain two. We're going to work this last step of double crochet four together, followed by a chain two, in between each of your puff stitches for the round below. So double crochet four together into the next space. Complete that cluster. Chain two. Carry on all the way round. Double crochet four together clusters in between the puffs, then chain two. So I'm just finishing up my very last double crochet four together cluster here. You should have 16 of these clusters and 16 chain two spaces in between. You'll also probably have something that looks a little bit buckled like this. Don't worry about that. Now to finish this round, do your final chain two and then find the chain two space across. So this one over here, and we're going to slip stitch into this. So skip that very first cluster you did of the round. We're going to slip stitch into the chain two space next to that. So just slip stitch, chain one, snip your yarn, pull that through, pull it tight, and you'll have something that looks like a right mess like this. That's absolutely fine. Crush it flat. Any buckling gets sorted in the next round. So if you want to go ahead and weave in your ends at this point, it's quite a good time to go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to quickly weave in my ends. Now for your final round, round four, this is the round in which we square off. So join your yarn to any of these chain two spaces from the row below. And we're going to start by chaining four. One, two, three, four. Now that counts as your very first treble stitch. Now we need two more treble stitches into this chain two space. So yarn over twice before going into that space. Draw up a loop. You'll have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two to complete the stitch. One more time, yarn over twice, go into that space, drop a loop, yarn over, and work through two at a time. Now into the next chain two space, work three double crochet stitches. That's just a yarn over once before you go into that stitch. One. Two. Three. Now into the next chain two space, work three half double crochet stitches. So yarn over, go into the stitch, pull up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook. And to complete your half double crochet, yarn over and pull through all three loops. So we go from tall, medium, short stitches as we square off. Now we need to go back up to make them tall up to the corner again. So after your three half double crochet stitches, three double crochet stitches into the next chain two space. Now we're going to form a corner using these really tall treble stitches that we did over here. So yarn over twice and then into that chain two space, work three treble crochet stitches. Now we're forming a corner here, so chain two and back into that same chain two space, work three more of these big tall treble stitches. Now we're going to work along the side. So into the next chain two space, three double crochet stitches. We're working our way back down in height again. then 3 half doubles into the next chain 2 space. Now back up we go, so 3 doubles into the next chain 2 space. Then form a corner, 3 treble stitches, chain 2, 3 treble stitches, all into that same chain 2 space. So you can see as you square it off, it flattens out your motif. So this side is still a bit higgledy-piggledy, but this side where I've been working the squaring off rounds are now nice and flat. So your corners are formed with 3 treble crochet, chain 2, 3 treble crochet. Then along the sides, 3 double crochet stitches, 3 half double crochet stitches, 3 double crochet stitches again, and then you're back to a corner. 3 trebles, chain 2, 3 trebles. So we're going to repeat this, squaring off the last 2 corners, but I will meet you before we finish up because we started with just half a corner, so we need to finish that one up before the round is done. So you go ahead and work another side, corner, and side along the bottom, and I'll meet you here in just a moment. Double crochet, half double crochet, corner. So these are my very last doubles of the squaring off round, and I'm right back to where we started. So you've got 3 corners nicely formed. 1, 2, 3. And we have this half corner hanging out right where we first started this round. So to finish off, we need to work back into this original chain 2 space where you first joined your yarn and work 3 trebles into that space. Then chain 2 and slip stitch to the top of that initial chain 4 that you made right at the very beginning. Chain 1, snip your yarn, leaving an end to weave in, pull it through, pull it tight, and then you can weave in any remaining ends that you might have. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you're a fan of granny squares in general, then I thoroughly recommend you go ahead and watch this video next, because that is also an awesome square. So until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.